So this is a very fundamental concept in statistics. It applies to coin flips and many of the other examples we discussed before. A candidate in an election might have a true chance that any given voter votes for him. Let's call this chance P, same as a coin flip. And of course, if P is larger than 0.5 in a two-person runoff, that person will not naturally win in most cases, not always. But as a statistician, we can't assess the true chance. So what we do is we form a sample. In coin flipping, we flip n coins. In elections, we ask n randomly chosen people. As we know, this gives us an estimated mean. It gives us also a variance and therefore a standard deviation. But what's new now is the confidence interval. And the confidence interval is not the same as the variance. In fact, drop the consideration of the variance. What this says is, based on the outcome, we believe for the parameter mu, this is the best guess we can get, which is usually the maximum likelihood estimate. But we are not quite certain. So we're going to assess a wider range in which we believe with high probability that whatever the outcome will be, that the outcome will be with high probability within this range. Very often, this range is defined as 95% chance that the final outcome falls into this range. That'll take some work to compute. So let's dive in.